Hi, Trying from Rock. Today video will be about differences between Siberian Husky and Alaskan Malamute. This video was requested on our Instagram by Harshi. Thank you for asking and enjoy this video. For a lot of people, those two breeds are very similar, but there are differences in all aspects. There are differences in their origin, in their appearance, and even in their personality. Let's start with the origin. It's true that both breeds were developed in winter climate areas. Siberian Husky was developed in Surprise, Siberia, by Chukchi people, and Alaskan Malamute was developed, Surprise again, in Alaska, by Inuit people. Both dogs have amazing ability to live in very cold areas, and both were used for transporting people and other stuff across frozen and rough terrain. Alaskan Malamute was used to pull a very heavy sled, while Siberian Husky pulled lighter sleds with people and supplies. Alaskan Malamutes were also used as seal hunters. On a photo, it can happen to mix up Siberian Husky and Alaskan Malamute, but in real life, you would never mix them up and you would never say that this is the same breed. And that is because one big difference, and that is their size. Alaskan Malamute is much, much bigger than Siberian Husky. Alaskan Malamute height is around 60 centimeters, while Husky height is only about 55 centimeters. That doesn't sound like much difference, but a Malamute is much more muscular and bigger in general. Another difference is in their eye color. If you will see a dog and you will be unsure if it's Husky or Malamute and he will have blue eyes, you can be 100% sure it's Husky. Malamutes have brown eyes, but never blue. Malamutes also have bigger and rounder heads, almost like wolf or bear. Husky head is more snippier, like fox head. Now let's talk about personality of both breeds. Malamutes are ideal family dogs. They are very people oriented, they are easygoing, friendly, and they just love being around small children. They have a lot of energy, but in comparison to Husky, they are way more laid back. Bad thing is that they can be a little bit stubborn sometimes. Husky is also a good family dog, but they are not so people oriented as Malamutes, and they are more independent dogs. On the other hand, they are better in socialization with other animals, and they do love being around smaller kids, just like Malamutes. As I said earlier, they have a lot of energy, and I mean really, really lot. Sometimes it might seem that you can never tire up a Husky. You will need to give him plenty of exercise to make him happy. And although Huskies are more independent, they are generally easier to train and they are more obedient. Both breeds are considered to be very healthy dogs. Alaskan Malamute lifespan is around 11 years, while Siberian Husky lifespan is around 13 years. Both breeds are prone to cataracts and hip dyslexia. And in addition, Huskies are also prone to elbow dyslexia and progressive retinal atrophy. Alaskan Malamute is prone to day blindness and chondro dyslexia. It's always almost impossible to say which dog is better because every dog is good at something and it really depends what are you expecting from your dog. But if you are still undecided if you will get Alaskan Malamute or Siberian Husky, you can look at Alaskan Husky. It's not purebred dog, actually it's dog defined by his purpose for use as a sled dog. He was bred in Alaska by mixing a lot of breeds, including Alaskan Malamute and Siberian Husky, but also German short-haired pointer or greyhound. Thank you for watching this video. If it was helpful for you, consider subscribing to this channel and check our social media links down in the description. If you have any other question about dogs, just ask me in comment and I will answer you with my reply or making new Q&A video. See you in the next video.